ஆண்டாள் திருவடிகளே சரணம். திருப்பாவை 10th பாசுரம். நோற்று சுவர்க்கம் புகுகின்ற அம்மனாய் மாற்றமும் தாராரோ வாசல் திறவாதார் நாற்ற துழாய் முடி நாராயணன் நம்மால் போற்றப்பறை தரும் புண்ணிய நாள் பண்டொரு நாள் கூற்றத்தின் வாய் வீழ்ந்த கும்பகர்ணனும் தோற்று முனக்கே பெருந்துயில்தான் தந்தானோ ஆற்ற அனந்தலுடையாய் அருங்கலமே தேற்றமாய் வந்து திறவேலோரெம்பாவாய். ஆண்டாள் இஸ் இன் த ப்ராசஸ் ஆஃப் வேக்கிங் அப் ஹர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் ஸோ தேட் தே கேன் ஜாயின் ஹர் ஃபார் த பாவை நோம்பு. ஷீ ஹஸ் ஆல்ரெடி வோக்கன் அப் 4 ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் ஃப்ரம் பாசுரம் 6 to 9 அண்ட் டுடே இன் த 10th பாசுரம் ஷீ இஸ் கோயின் டு வேக் அப் த 5th ஃப்ரெண்ட். திஸ் கேர்ள் இஸ் த பெஸ்ட் ஃப்ரெண்ட் ஆஃப் கிருஷ்ணா இட் சீம்ஸ் this 10th friend. That is why Krishna secretively comes to her house now and then. And Andal knows this. So, when she is going to this girl's house, she is having an opinion that probably even at this moment, Krishna is in her house. And apparently she is right too. Because she has her own reasons to prove her suspicion. So when she's calling out to this girl, she says that you are indeed our leader. You are our celebrated heroine. Ammanai, she calls out to her. Ammanai means one who is a celebrity, the celebrated one. So you are our celebrated leader. Andal says, why are you our leader? Why are you the celebrated one? You know, because you are the one who has accomplished the task. Notru chuvarkam pugugindra ammanai, she says. Now, these people have a task in hand, and the task in hand to be accomplished is to attain Krishna. And anybody who attains what they want to attain is called an achiever, and the place for achievers is in heaven. So, for these girls, heaven means Krishna Anubhava or the experience of Krishna. So, this particular girl, the 10th girl, has already reached that heaven. She's saying, Notru Chuvargam. Chuvargam refers to Swargam or heaven. And this girl has already attained this heaven of experiencing Krishna because she has finished the task in hand. Notru refers to completing something like a vrata or some effort to achieve what she has achieved. So this way, this girl is the accomplished one according to Andal. Because Andal is saying that she knows that now at this moment Krishna is with that girl. And that is why this girl is remaining silent. She is not replying back at all to her friends. Because it seems that she has been caught red-handed. So she is silent. So Andal and her friends outside are asking, Matramum Tararo Vasal Tiravadar. Why don't you answer us? Matramum tararo. Matram means reply. Why don't you reply to us? Or fine, if you don't want to reply, at least come and open the door. You're not even doing that. Vasal tiravadar. We know that you are now in association with Krishna. Because we can smell the tulasi, they are saying. Natra tudai mudi narayanan nammal. These girls are saying that we can get the fragrance of the tulasi. Natram refers to fragrance. Natra tulai mudi narayanan, they say. Tulai is tulasi. And this tulasi is worn on the head only by Narayana. Tulai mudi narayanan, they say. Mudi refers to the holy head of the Lord. Lord Narayana. It seems the tulsi can be worn on the head only by Lord Narayana. Anybody else should not be wearing the tulsi on the head. So, we know that the bearer of the tulasi on the head, Narayana, is with you because we are getting the fragrance of that. So, now to this, the girl inside wants to answer. She wants to defend herself, trying to say that Narayana or Krishna is not with her at that time. So, she tries telling these girls that, see, Andal and other friends, I had this Tulsi Mala with me since past few days. I've been having it. And you know that the Tulsi which has adorned the head of the Lord doesn't lose fragrance even after it withers away. So, you're getting the fragrance of that old Tulsi, that is all. The girls outside are much smarter. They are saying that, can't we differentiate between the fragrance of old Tulasi and new Tulasi? We are damn sure that Narayana Krishna is with you right now. So the girl inside laughs and says, my dear friends, you're talking about Narayana being with me. That's true. Narayana is with everybody. We all know, we have heard the Bahuvrihi Samasam. What is that? Naraha Ayanam Yasya Saha. Meaning, Narayana is present everywhere in the world. He is omnipresent. So, obviously, he is present here with me also. So, what is the big deal? He is present there also with you people. So, like that, he is present with me also. Then the girls say, you talk very intelligently, but we know that Narayana in the form of Krishna is present with you right now. You know why? Because this Narayana, this Krishna is Nammal. He is our Mal, they say. Mal is one who has extraordinary affection for his beloved one. So, the Lord Narayana is called Mal because he has immense affection for the whole universe. He has warmth, love and affection to give to everybody who approach him. And so he is called as Mal. And he is Nammal. He is our Lord, our Mal, the one who loves us so much. So, he is so fond of you that he has now come down for your sake. Now, what do we mean by the Lord coming down for somebody? We mean that the Lord manifests himself so that the observer or the devotee can feel his presence or see him. And that is exactly what has happened to you, my dear friend, Andal says. Lord Krishna has come down to your house to be with you and to grace you, just to prove that he is reciprocating the devotion that you are showing to him. He is bestowing you with a lot of affection and acceptance for all the devotion that you are giving to him. That is why he is present with you. Narayanan Nammal. Now to this, the girl inside has no answer. So, the girls outside continue to speak further and say that it seems that you are not ready to accept that Lord Krishna is there with you right now. Fine. If we take it for granted that Lord Krishna is not with you right now and you're not spending your time with him right now, then we have to believe that probably you're sleeping. If you're still sleeping after having us spoken so much, if you can go back to sleep, then it means that you have probably won in a competition meant for sleepers. And you know, the world famous sleeper Kumbhakarna, it looks like you have defeated even Kumbhakarna in that sleep competition. And when you defeat somebody, the person who is defeated honors the winner with what he has. Like if two kings are fighting and one king loses, then the losing king gives his kingdom to the winner. So in this case, the competition was a sleeping competition or a sleeping battle, we can say, which was won by this girl, the 10th friend. And Kumbhakarna had his wealth of sleep, which he has now surrendered to this 10th friend. So, Andal is saying, it looks like after winning the competition against Kumbhakarna, Kumbhakarna has awarded the trophy of sleeping to you. So all his sleep has been transferred to you as a gift, as a trophy for winning that sleep competition.
போற்றப்பறைதரும் புண்ணிய நாள் பண்டொரு நாள் கூற்றத்தின் வாய் வீழ்ந்த கும்பகர்ணனும் தோற்றுமுனக்கே பெருந்துயில் தான் தந்தானோ.
The story has been explained in this line. Let's try to understand it word by word. Andal is saying, பெருந்துயில் தான் தந்தானோ. Great sleep has been awarded to you as a prize. By whom?
கும்பகர்ணனும் தோற்றுமுனக்கே பெருந்துயில் தான் தந்தானோ.
கும்பகர்ணா, having lost the competition against you, தோற்றும் has given you this பெருந்துயில், this great sleep as a trophy. And who is this Kumbhakarna? She gives an adjective which is very interesting for Kumbhakarna. She says that this Kumbhakarna was that one who lost the battle against Rama. Which Rama? The great virtuous king, crown prince Rama.
Punniyanal, Punniyan refers to the great soul Rama. Pandurunal, once upon a time, கூற்றத்தின் வாய் வீழ்ந்த கும்பகர்ணன்.
கும்பகர்ணா lost that battle against Rama. Now it is said that கும்பகர்ணா lost this battle against Rama. Not that Rama defeated Kumbhakarna. Andal has taken care to put words like that. Why is it so? Because the Lord actually never wants to defeat or demean anybody. He always wants virtue to stand at height. And he doesn't want vices to take a front seat and rule over the world. So, whenever the Lord comes down as incarnations or avatars, his main aim is to do sadhu paritrana or saving devotees. That is what he has said in the Gita too. Paritranaya sadhunam. That is his motive, to take care of the devotees and to protect them. Now, in the process of protecting devotees, sometimes he has to defeat and get rid of enemies. So, that comes as something secondary. So, that is said by the Lord as Vinashaya cha dushkritam. He also ends up defeating some people for the purpose of saving his devotees. And thus, he establishes dharma or virtue. Dharma samsthapanarthaya sambhavami yuge yuge. The Lord says, I take incarnations basically for protecting the virtuous, and during the course of protection, I may have to sometimes destroy the evil, and thus I establish dharma. So, here also, the Lord did not go and defeat Kumbhakarna like it was his aim. It so happened that Kumbhakarna, despite being a good soul, supported the wrong person, Ravana, and he knew even before the battle that Ravana was going to lose the battle. Despite that, he supported his brother, and so he very willingly submitted himself to Rama, and he knew that defeat for him was the right end, and thus Kumbhakarna stood defeated at the hands of Rama. He accepted the defeat very gracefully, since he had some piousness in him. He tried to advise Ravana that he was doing the wrong thing by abducting Sita and not giving her back. But Ravana wouldn't listen. So Kumbhakarna yielded to his brother's request and fought on his side, knowing that he would be defeated. But he was only happy to be defeated at the hands of Rama. And that is why Andal is speaking about Kumbhakarna here. Just to show us how merciful the Lord is, and he does not want to actually destroy anybody. But the evil itself at some point of time willingly gets destroyed at the hand of the Lord. So this beautiful teaching Andal gives us through this pasuram. And she is continuing with the story along with her friends, saying that it looks like you have won a trophy from Kumbhakarna, and this trophy of sleep is making you sleep all the more. And you are sleeping as though you are the most lethargic one. Atra ananda ludayai, she says. So now this girl inside finally asks one question. You are saying What not about me? You're saying I have won against Kumbhakarna. I am a sleepy girl and that I am lethargic. Then why at all do you want to take me along? Why are you sitting and shouting in front of my house when you're thinking that I am not actually worth coming with you? I am so lethargic. I am so bad. Why do you want me to come with you? She asks. Then Andal laughs and says, oh, we never said you are lethargic in the bad sense. We only said that you don't want to become active and join us, but you want to enjoy the lot alone, which is not right. You are actually so dear to us, Arungalame. You're dear to us because you're dear to Krishna. You're his best friend. So obviously we have no choice to leave you and go. And if we leave you and go, we would lose something. So we really plead you to come and join with us. Listening to this, the girl inside smilingly comes out and joins the Sandal Goshti. It is said that this gopi had her room upstairs in the house. That is why Andal is saying, Tetramayvandhi Thiravelorembavai. Hearing these girls call her, now that the gopi has decided to come down, she may hurry and come down and probably have a fall in the way. So Andal is scared. So she says, please come slowly. Tetramayvandhi Thiravelorembavai. So Purvacharyas say that this girl had her room in the first floor of her house. And she came down very happily for these girls. The significance behind this girl being present in the first floor is that she is somebody who has already reached Swarga or already reached the goal individually. So she was at a cadre above the other girls. So to signify that, they have said that she lives on the first floor. But having Bhagavat Anubhava or the experience of the Lord alone is not a great thing. We should always share this experience with the interested ones. And so this girl comes down from her level and goes along with the other friends to again go towards the goal and enjoy him and experience bliss.